Wenton up and ready.
Seconds out, round four.
Fourth round.
Wenton should be putting some power into that jab. Let's keep Lloyd off. He's just continually looking for the right hand, just a feeling punch.
And Lloyd trying to put some distance between himself and Wenton. Wenton moving implacably forward. And then well, the good news is it's not getting any worse. The bad news is it's certainly not getting any better.
Pace is low considerably.
Well, it's certainly more than the human frame could stand to take up, keep up the pace of the first couple of rounds. Wenton boxing pretty sensibly now. Those opening two rounds, which John Coyle, I'm sure, will have given to him on a 10-9 margin, given him a useful cushion. But every time Wenton tries to throw a big right, it's getting through. The problem is, with that left eye damage, Lloyd just can't see it coming. 2 minutes gone.
Oh,
good right hand. And that almost... And Lloyd off his feet. This, I feel, will be the punch that wins the fight for Wenton, and when it he does.
Has he taken the best Wenton can offer, though? That's the question.
That could be, that could be.
Wenton gets very reckless when he mixes inside, and you don't know who's going to come off the best there.
And these thudding right hands, each one zeroing in on the damaged eye. Again. Well, it's everything we thought it would be, and a little bit more as well, Nicky.
Yeah, this is Wenton. I think it's the good right hand. Yeah. But he stood up to it.
It's the cumulative effect, though.
Well, that's right.
You know, you can take one, you can take another, but eventually there will come a time when one right hand that is probably no harder than others you've taken finally just is the straw that breaks the camel's back. Wenton's still looking fresh.
10 seconds, Johnny.
Security doing a pretty good job on the crowd, happily. Fifth round. Wenton, the champion in the silver. Lloyd, the challenger in the black. John Coyle giving a superlative performance, refereeing this contest. Adopting just the right touch. Letting it flow as much as he can. And that is what is contributing to an electric contest so far.
Both landed good punches. I wouldn't bet on it, Dave, obviously, but I've got a feeling that Lloyd may cause a shock here. Everything's gone against him, but Wenton, as I said, so reckless.
Well, while he's still upright, he can still pull off a surprise. And he does have a decent dig, and he has wobbled Wenton in round one. Hasn't let him down yet, though. He's been down himself three times. Oh, goodness. Oh, goodness. And the tragedy is for Lloyd, he's the only one in the hall who can't see them coming. To give ground, and the right hand is cocked, and Wenton driving him around the ring, tries a right uppercut, doesn't quite connect.
And Wenton knows that right hand is a punch.
Well, I did say this would be the decisive punch. It could be. Once again, Lloyd's head is jerked back. Oh, he's got him down with a left hook.
Desperate.
He's up at nine, but for how long? And will John Coyle let it continue? I don't think so. It's all over. It's all over. In round five, Wenton has won on a fifth round stoppage. The crowd stunned. They can hardly believe it. Look at that four. A crowd reacting to defeat, and look at that, to a corner reacting to a win. Superb performance from Wenton. And we will be talking to Richie Wenton in a moment. And, well, why some are booing, I do not know. This is how it finished, Nicky.
Oh, it was unbelievable fighting. Great punches. He knew the right hand was the one.
Ladies and gentlemen, in the 2 minutes, 25 seconds of round five, the referee, John Coyle, has stopped the contest. Poor Lloyd being in no continue. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner and still the Bantamweight champion, Richie Wenton.
Magnificent performance from Wenton. He took on Lloyd, he took on the crowd, he beat them both.
And ladies and gentlemen, your appreciation please for a young man who's taken part in what must be one of the fights of the year.
Well, as I say, we will be talking to Richie Wenton after the break.
And ladies and gentlemen, can we ask you to clear the ring to make the belt presentation?
And he will get the Lonsdale belt back again. Remember, three notches, and it's yours for life. He's got two already. He's won the title. He's defended it. And the next defence, we suspect, might well be against Michael Aldis. That would be some fight. Two contrasting styles. But I would think, Nicky, that that sort of performance would give any challenger pause for thought.
Yeah, it was unbelievable. It was very good boxing, very powerful punches in there from the champion. I was very impressed.
Let's take a look at how it ended once one more time.
Yeah, he knew the right hand was the punch that Lloyd couldn't see, and then he came out of the left. This is right hand. That was the knockdown before the final assault.
And that's what they're fighting for, the Lonsdale belt. Enamel, gold plate.
Still the best belt in world boxing.
Still is the best. It's there's something very special about that belt. There it is. Well, what we're going to do now is take a short break, let things cool down, we hope, just a little bit. We're going to get Richie Wenton to our commentary position at ringside. And we're going to have a word with him. We also have got more live boxing for you. So lots of good stuff to come here on ProBox. That's the face of victory. We'll be right back. Don't go too far away. Join me and the champ in just a moment. Back, I've got Richie Wenton with me. That is the belt. Richie, you went out, you met fire with fire tonight.
I'm the champion of Great Britain. I'm number one in Europe. I'm number two in the Commonwealth. I'm number one in Great Britain. And that's the man's behind me, basically, I think. I mean, there's two people I'd like to thank before I say anything, you know, and that's Senior Sam Adair down in North Devon, who's my mentor for this fight. Plus, I'd like to thank the British Boxing Board of Control for keeping my rankings as one, two, one in Britain, one in Europe, and two in the Commonwealth. And, you know, and I'm going on to bigger and better things now. Maybe Nassim Ahmed, maybe take the European title fight, defense title fight, you know, against the European super bantamweight title. I'm number one super bantamweight in Great Britain, and let's see anyone take it off me.
Now listen, this must have been like coming into the lion's den for you tonight.
Well, you heard the crowd, you're the experience for the crowd. You know, I've done a job,
Richie, and I went from there.
Listen,
I'm the only woman.
See this girl?
We did it, you know, Dad.
She's part of the mentor with Senior Sam Adair. Plus me training Sam Adair. There's too many people I'd have to thank you. You know, I'd have to be here all day. But, you know, I've done it, and I've done it for Liverpool and Devon.
Well, look, we're going to show you how it started now, the first round. Talk us through the first round. Watch on the screen there.
He's a nice mover. I was looking at him. He can't usually take a punch. He's open for right hands. And the only way I could catch him was to slip and counterpunch him. And I wasn't going to let him off the hook as soon as I caught him. Yeah, he was trying to...
And this is how you finished it.
Yeah, I hit him with a good right hand. I'm not going to do a Nassim Ahmed and go, wow, look at that, dig it. I'm not a Nassim Ahmed, I'm going to say. I've done a boxing, I've done a talking in a ring, and that's that, you know.
Was there any doubt in your mind that this was the way the fight would go?
No, I honestly went in to do a 12-rounder. That was the pace I was going to fight, a 12-round fight. You know, I had to take a few shots to get in there. I've been out the ring 5 months. I'm the champion of Great Britain, and I proved it. I showed my experience and my class tonight.
And what does that Lonsdale belt mean to you?
Too much. It means too much. The kid's going to have to knock me out and keep me on the floor for him to take this belt off me. Anyone is going to have to destroy me to take this belt off me. That fight. I dedicate that fight to Bradley Stone and his family. And he never lost to a bum fighter, what he showed me last fight against Neil Swain. He lost to a champion.
Well, Richard, you proved a lot of things to a lot of people tonight. Well done. Well done, the fans.
Yeah!
And I think that's a good point to leave it. We've got more action.